If you have tried keto and you give up because it's eating deep in your pocket, I would like you to put it in the comment section below. Tell me for how long you lasted during the diet, why you think it's actually expensive, what are you buying? Because this will determine whether you did it the right way or not. Hello guys, welcome to the video where I am all about living my life at 40 years and above. Today guys, I'm going to be debunking the belief that keto diet is expensive, especially in Nigeria or anywhere in the world. You know, a lot of people believe that the keto diet is expensive, and I don't think that is correct. So if you want to hear my opinion on this issue, kindly hit the like button, kindly subscribe, and also make sure you turn on the bell notification. That way you will always be the first to know whenever I release an awesome video like this. Come on guys, let's do this. Welcome back to the video guys. If you're new here, you're most welcome. My name is Ernest. I'm a health and fitness enthusiast, and I will encourage you to consider subscribing because my videos are specially designed for you to get your groove back, to get healthy, and to live a longer life. If you're a returning subscriber, I appreciate you so much. Thank you very much for encouraging me by watching my videos. I hope you will learn something today. Alright, let's dive into the video. Ketogenic diet. Keto diet is an awesome diet. I mean, it's one of the best diets out there. Right, if you really want to lose weight, if you really want to be healthy, I think one of the best diets to embark on is the ketogenic diet. It's that simple. You know, but sometimes when you hear the name ketogenic diet, I think maybe that is what scares people. That what makes people feel as if it's a kind of a very big thing to do, something that make you deny you all the good things of life. No, in fact, ketogenic diet is very sweet because you still enjoy a lot of sweet things, a lot of healthy food. Okay, so if you must have a healthy life, if you must lose weight, you should first of all prepare for a lifestyle change. Okay, but what happens is people don't like change. Change is always resisted. But at the end of the day, when you go through this change, you'll be like, oh, why did I do this late? I mean, if you want to have a quality life in this world, I'm talking to the elderly people here, maybe people from 40 years and above. If you are less than 40, maybe 20, 25, maybe 30, you can get away with a lot of things. Because as you grow older, a lot of things changes in your system. The major thing that changes is your metabolism. Your metabolism slows down. You understand? You notice that when you are much younger, you will eat. Once you eat, in the next 2-3 hours, you are hungry again. Your stomach is empty. Apart from the fact that you move more, your metabolism is also very, very high. So it digests everything and takes them out of your system. By the time you get to 35, 40, it's no longer like that. Those metabolism slows down. It doesn't break down the food as fast as it's used to anymore. So it lets the food lie down in your stomach. And what happens? Insulin comes in and converts everything to sugar and store it in your belly. Okay? So now what does keto diet do? Keto diet is just to ensure that you don't have excess carbohydrate, excess blood sugar lying around in your bloodstream, lying around in your system. Right, so you reduce, since your metabolism is not strong enough to break down those excess sugar, excess carbohydrate as it's used to, the keto diet now makes sure that you take in little amount of excess, little amount of sugar and carbohydrate. That's all. I mean, that's just it. That's it. Alright, so now, I'm not trying to say, this video is not about what keto diet is, but to discuss the cost of ketogenic diet. Now, I've heard people say that keto is expensive, keto is expensive. I don't think so, because in the long run, it's cheaper. Now, when you're on a keto diet, it's satiating, because by the time you have fats will keep you full for longer. Proteins will keep you full for longer. and it's satiating. I mean, your hunger hormone will be taken care of, all right? It activates the satisfaction hormone called leptin, all right, and suppresses the hunger hormone called ghrelin. Right, so you find out that at the number of times you eat, the rate at which you eat will slow. The rate at which you snack will come down. So all those snacking and eating several times will be off the chart, meaning that you will spend less. It's just that by the time you go shopping, you find out that you are spending more at that time, depending on what you are buying. Because some of us will just go out there and they go to the supermarket and they start buying all those imported items. They start going for berries, salmon, tunas, you know, those expensive things that are imported, and they are not even healthy because they are packed with a lot of chemicals and preservatives. Right? By the time you go for such foreign things, of course, they will eat deep into your pocket. But I suggest that you go keto locally. Look around what you have in your locality and use them. There are a lot of low-carb food around. Right, so if you're going for salmon, you go for mackerel. They are very, very affordable in the market. You go and get the mackerel and you use that. You mustn't go for salmon, because you see a white man talking about salmon, which is also expensive for them there. You want to go for salmon that has been imported there. It will not go well. Now, you must not have berries. Berries are awesome. If you can get the organic one, if you can go enter into any farm in Nigeria and get berries, the blackberry, the blueberries, fine, awesome. But it's not available, so why kill yourself by going to the supermarket to get them, alright? Because they will not even do the job at the end of the day. So you just forget about food when you are doing keto diet. You go for vegetables. There are a lot of vegetables that are very, very affordable. Cabbage is there, broccoli is there, cauliflower is there, you know, kale is there, alright? So those are not even very expensive. But even if they are, you can go for the very cheap ones like cabbage. Cabbage is packed with a lot of nutrients. You can have cabbage and spinach and broccoli and cauliflower as your veggies. When you use those ones, you also have parsley, you have celery. Those ones are very, very affordable. You can avoid the very expensive one like asparagus, eggplants, all those ones. Anyone that is too expensive for you, leave. You still have carrots, you have bell peppers, you have tomatoes, you have green beans. Those who are very awesome and they are very affordable. For fat, you go for avocado, alright? So, when you look around you and go for what is locally produced where you are home and dry. And the keto diet will ensure that you live a healthy life. It will stop you from snacking, like I said earlier. It will not raise your blood sugar. You find out that you are happier and your body is stable. One thing I want us to ask ourselves when we want to start ketogenic diet is, what am I trying to achieve? What is the aim of this diet now? The aim is not just to lose weight though, because something will make you lose weight. You can't just start a diet and say, okay, I've started the ketogenic diet and I'll start losing weight. No, you have to allow yourself to get into ketosis. You have to get into ketosis. If you are lazy, you are on a diet, you went to the market and you buy all the chicken, the beef, and all those things you think they are expensive. Yes, they might be expensive at that time. And you still nibble on sweet sugar here and there while you are on keto. You won't be in ketosis. So you even eat more. Because keto, the job of keto is to take you to a place where you don't eat much anymore, where you don't feel hungry anymore by getting to ketosis. If you don't get to ketosis and you're on your second week of keto, my brother, what are you doing? You are not doing keto. And you give up and say that it's expensive. No, keto is not expensive if you do it properly. If you follow the rules, just a little patience, give yourself 1 week, tighten up, and you get into ketosis. Once you get into ketosis, that is the goal. You find out that you don't feel hungry anymore. Because what makes you feel hungry most of the time is the excess sugar in your system. Not that you are hungry, but you have excess sugar. What happens when you have excess sugar in your system by eating excess carbohydrate or even sugary stuff like soda or processed food? What happens is that once you eat those, your blood sugar increases and it is not good for you. Now, your body, your pancreas will release insulin to go and mop up those blood sugars. When they mop it up and they are in excess, what happens? They convert it to fat and store it. As soon as that happens, your body lacks the little amount of sugar that even requires to function. That is a state called hypoglycemia. Now, once that happens, your body will start craving for more sugar immediately to replace it. So you'll be in this roller coaster journey. You keep eating and they're storing that fat, you're eating more. So, but when you allow yourself, just discipline yourself for just 1 week, concentrate on the keto diet, eat only healthy fat, healthy protein, and very low carbohydrates for vegetable, and allow yourself get into ketosis. A lot of people have done keto and they never got into ketosis, and they come out and say keto is expensive. When you are able to get into ketosis, it is the best thing that will happen to you any day, anytime. It's so awesome. You will feel so energetic, so happy, so alive, so new. And you won't have any need to say you are the keto is expensive, because at the long run, it pays you off. Do you know what it means to be fat? It's a lot of work. When you are fat, you eat so much. You eat so much because you have a lot of cells to feed. You are close to pre-diabetes, which is not healthy for anyone. If you have tried keto and you give up because it's eating deep in your pocket, I would like you to put it in the comment section below. Tell me for how long you lasted during the diet, why you think it's actually expensive, what are you buying, because this will determine whether you did it the right way or not. When I started my keto, the only thing I actually bought that are a little bit expensive are the fats, like the coconut oil, and maybe the olive oil or avocado oil, depending. But among these three types of oil, the coconut oil is quite more affordable. So I went for that. I didn't go for the, okay, the olive oil that I even got was just a small one that I used for my salad dressing. But for cooking, I used the coconut oil. Now, what are you actually cooking? Because a little dash of that is even enough for you. If you are doing steak, you are roasting your meat or you're frying it, you can probably just steam it a little before you put it on fire and fry it, and just a little quantity of oil is okay. That oil you bought can last for you for like 2-3 months. There are a lot of vegetables, like I said earlier. You have pumpkin leaves, we call it ogu. You have the spinach, you can just plant it around your garden, around your backyard, and it grows like wildfire. And spinach is a very wonderful vegetable. Nutrient dense, very, very awesome. Even if you use spinach and cabbage more often as your vegetable, you are home and dry, you are good. All right, so the next thing is your protein, your beef, your chicken, your fish. Don't go for all these poultry fishes, all these catfish, because they feed them with a lot of chemicals and food that are not okay, right? Don't go for poultry, chicken too, but even if you must, you can have those ones. They are still better than not doing the keto at all. But for our beef, most of our beefs are field grazed. They don't have any, we don't have poultry for cows, right? So they graze naturally, they are all organic. Right? But if you can afford the native chickens, you know, that are grazed, that graze around, you know, without being fed with a lot of soybean and or whatnot, even their own feathers, that would be better. Okay, so that's it. Then the vegetable is the vegetable that is everywhere. You can just get any vegetable, turn it into a soup, turn it into a salad, and you are home and dry. What is so expensive there? Really, nothing. Now, by the time you get into ketosis, you don't even eat more. You start doing your intermittent fasting. You can eat like twice in a day. If you must snack, you go for peanuts. How much is peanuts? You go for cashew nuts. How much is cashew nuts? Then the other nuts that you hear them talk about, macadamia nut, walnut, and the almond, all those ones are expensive, and we don't even have it here in Nigeria. Now, even the ones you are buying in the shelf in the supermarket are not even good for you. So why buy them? Why buy them? Because those ones will even kick you out of ketosis, or will never even allow you to get into ketosis. Okay, if you start ketosis and you never reach to a point whereby you can go and forget that you need to eat or you have not eaten, then you've never been into ketosis. Okay? Now, I'm the kind of person that I don't really, and that will even make you, when you eat, even if you want to eat, as long as it's vegetable, you can eat as much vegetable as you want. It's difficult for you to go have excess carb by eating vegetables. it's difficult, right? Because I've never checked my calories. I don't look at calories because I'm not really that a serious person, you know. Checking my calories, measuring my food makes it look too serious and very uncomfortable. I don't do that. I only eat like twice or once in a day. I mean, what can I eat at a sitting that will not make me exceed my macros, that will not start measuring it? And I feel good. I was able to lose over 30 kg now, you know? So the things I eat are very, very, I'm on a low diet carb. I cannot say I'm still on ketosis. I'm doing ketosis now because once in a while I have rice, I have fruits. Those are the only things I added in my diet. Once you take off the rice, maybe rice, beans, sweet potato, I'm doing ketogenic diet because I still have my veggies every day, have my proteins and fats. Alright, so once in a while I just add a little rice to it. So the basic thing here is, it's not by force to be in ketosis, but it's recommended. I recommend, and I think it's by force for you to live a healthy life. I think it's recommended, not really by force, nothing is by force really, but it's recommended that you try to live a healthy life, especially when you're getting older. You know, for the younger generation, fine, they can get away with a lot of things. Like I said earlier, their metabolic system pumps very hard. Now, I don't know if I've been able to convince you that keto can be done successfully in Nigeria without breaking the bank, or anywhere in the world, by going for the things you can afford and not go wild. Okay, so if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, kindly subscribe so that this kind of content will be coming your way at least 3 times every week. I upload on Tuesdays, Wednesdays and Thursdays, and you don't want to miss it. Alright, so having said that, I think I will draw the curtain right here. Alright, so see you some other time next week. Ciao.